Hi YouTube, my name's Drew and you're watching Drawing with Drew. Thanks for tuning in for another one of these videos. If you haven't seen the first few, then you can go back and check them out. I've been using my iPad Air 3 now for approximately 2 months, and I just wanted to share a few things of actually what I've been using it for. I know that when I was first researching this, I was kind of thinking to myself, do I need an iPad? What else would I use it for aside from just art, because that's gonna be the primary thing that I have. I also have drawing tablets already, so I thought to myself, is it worth it for me to go ahead and spend more money buying another tablet? And I would say yes, it has been worth it for me, and I'm gonna share those apps with you now. So here's what I do on a typical day with the iPad. So by far my number one app that I use every single day, and the reason why I primarily bought this iPad, is for the Procreate app, which is, you know, a drawing tool. So it really will elevate your game when it comes to art. It offers you many different styles of brushes. It works absolutely beautifully. Now, from there, the next thing that I use it for is Instagram, obviously. I will then finish my drawing. Once it's done, I will share it and I'll upload it to my Instagram account. I'll link it down below if you're interested in checking it out. And as I said in previous videos, what I've been doing for the last 2 months or more, since the pandemic started, I've been posting a comic every single day on here. That's the second thing that I use it for. The next reason why I bought this, and one thing that I wanted to kind of achieve when getting this, is to kind of stay more organized, organize my finances, organize my, you know, activities, and just remember what I've done in certain days. So what I did was I purchased the Notability app, which is a very well-known app among students for taking notes and whatnot. And then in Keynotes, I designed a digital planner, which helps me to keep my everything together. So let me show you. So this is the Notability app. So I designed these two calendars. They're exactly the same, but different color schemes. So I'll show you my new one right now. This is the classic version. And it's just a PDF document, essentially. But what happens is at the very beginning here, so here's the planner, here's the classic version that I made. It's just a black and white, very unisex style. And what's nice about it is you can, you know, keep all of your information, your dates, your appointments, everything in here. And then you can toggle from month to month along the side and record all of your information. And on the right side here, you have different tabs where, like, if you have animal records, you have home maintenance, health, different things like that. So I just created this using Keynotes. It's free software. You can even do it on your iPad. I did it on my Mac computer. It's just a little bit easier to navigate things with a mouse, I find, but you can do it on your iPad as well. And so I use that every day or thereabouts whenever I have something important to include. And I find that it works really well. If you're interested in picking one up, by no means am I pushing this, but I'll link it down below to my Etsy shop. I'm selling them for just under $10 Canadian if you're interested. The next thing that I use my iPad for now is for reading, especially comics, different comics. So what I've got here is Hoopla, and it's through my actual local library. So this is kind of a tip for perhaps people who are living in and around the world. You might have a library close to you. If you have a library card, you can sign up and often get free downloads of different books, different movies, and depending on where you live, you might get unlimited or you might get a number. I have access to 9 different downloads per month, depending on the material, the media form. But all I do in this case is Hoopla is my one, and I've been reading a comic called Farmhand. It's really awesome, by my favorite comic book artist, Robert Guillory. And that's a good option for you if you don't have access to things like Netflix or whatever else, and you want free content, then you can just go to your library and hopefully get it for free. The next thing that I use my iPad for nowadays, especially, just worked out well that one of my other computers that I was using for my business just kind of crashed on me and hasn't been working well. So I use it for my eBay account. I do all of my sales through there, and I can easily hook, I've hooked it up to my printer that is Bluetooth, and I can prepare all my orders. Then I can just directly print off my labels, send it there, and send them out the door. So it makes things really easy. You can do it wherever you want to. You can take pictures of your items if you're an eBay seller like me, and put it on there from anywhere technically in the world. So that's nice. But essentially, those are the things that I use it for primarily. So if there's anything that you would like more information about, whether or not it's regarding the iPad Air 3 or something I talked about in this video, please leave me a comment down below. I'd be happy to answer your questions. And if you're interested in checking out some more of my videos, hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.